3. Good morning, class. The topic for the day is patent. Alright, so as we know, we are dealing with intellectual property rights or intellectual property law. Alright, so we have finished copyrights. What do we understand by copyrights? And in our last class, we have already done trademark. Now we understand the concept of trademark. Now today's topic for the day is patent. Alright, so today we will learn what is the meaning of patent, why is it so important, and what are the things that has to be there in order to get patent. Alright, so let's start. What does patent means? Patents are rights granted to an inventor. To whom? Patents. When the word patent comes, it's a right given to whom? To an inventor, that allows them to exclude all others from making, using or selling their invention for a specific period of time. So the main purpose to have patent under intellectual property rights is it gives rights. Patent gives rights to whom? To the inventor, to the person who invents a new thing. Alright, it gives protection so that the others will not be able to use it or to sell it or to claim it without his or her consent or prior permission. Alright, just for example, we all use Facebook, isn't it? And we all know who has invented Facebook? Mark Zuckerberg, isn't it? So Mark Zuckerberg over here is the inventor of Facebook. We can call him the inventor or the father of Facebook. Alright, so Facebook is his invention, isn't it? He was a software developer. He has invented Facebook. Now in today's time, nobody can claim or use his Facebook without his permission. Alright, so the basic concept for patent is very simple. It is to protect the rights, the invention that the creator has created. Alright, moving on to next, the basic idea of this system is to encourage the inventors. Is to what? Encourage. In what way? So that when a person invents a new thing, his work, his hard work will not go in vain. So that his hard work, his new invention will be protected, will not be stolen by any other people. Alright? To encourage the inventors to safeguard their own creation. Now the second thing is, patent safeguards their creation. Alright? Books, movies and some artwork cannot be patented. Now we should always remember that books, movies, arts, this can't be under patent. Why? The reason is copyright. We have already done, isn't it? So if I write a book or if I make a movie, then I can't claim for patent, but instead I can always go for copyright. Are you understanding? All right however, one can protect these assets under the law of copyright. As I have already said, under intellectual property rights, we have copyright. Alright? So, what are the inventions that can be put under patent? Number one, there are basically three requirements. Alright? Number one is, it must be novel and one of its kind. So, what are the basic requirements? The number one point is, it must be novel and of its kind, meaning it must be completely new, it must not be old, it must be completely new and it must be completely the creator's creation. Again, I will take a simple example, Facebook. It has been created by the creator. Alright, now in today's time, I can't just step in and say, no, I want to use your Facebook, I want to get income from your Facebook because it is protected by patent and I can't claim it saying that it was my invention because it is someone else's invention. All right. Another example, is like, let's assume that I am a software developer. All right, I am a software developer, and I create something new. It's a new software. It's a completely new software. In that situation, I can claim for patent. But if I say that WhatsApp is my invention, all right, and if I try to claim it, then I can't, because it has been protected. The invention of the creator has been protected by what? By patent, under intellectual property rights. All right, the next point is it must be unique in itself. It must be unique in itself. An improvement in the current technology by an individual cannot be patented. Now, for example, before WhatsApp, when WhatsApp was first launched, it was completely new, isn't it? Before that, we had nothing called WhatsApp, isn't it? So it was a completely new creation by the inventor. So the inventor or the creator of WhatsApp got the right to claim for patent. Now, WhatsApp is there, we all use it, and in time to time, there is a software update for WhatsApp, isn't it? There are more features getting added in WhatsApp, isn't it? So now, if I will create a new, if I will add a new thing in WhatsApp, then I can't claim for patent because it has already been created by someone else. What I have done is I have just added few new things. Just because I have added few new things in WhatsApp, that doesn't make me the creator. All right, this is what number two point is trying to tell us. Now moving on to next is, it must be useful. It must be useful. WhatsApp, it is of great use, isn't it? It should add value to the life of the common man. All right, and it must not benefit or support the use of illegal things, or must not be used of any immoral purpose. Now, what does that mean? Again, if I am a software developer and if I develop a software, a hacking software, all right, now if I develop a hacking software which will create problems, if I create a bug, for example, or any virus which will hamper, which will damage our whole computer system, then at that moment of time, I can't claim for patent. Why? Because it is harming our society. It is being a harmful software. Alright? So in these three circumstances, we can either claim it or we can't. Alright? Moving on to next is, what inventions are non-patentable? Alright? So what are the inventions that cannot be claimed under patent rights? Section 3 and 5 of Indian Patent Act 1970. Section 3 and 5. Alright? So, Section 3 and 5 under the Patents Right Act of 1970 says that any method of agriculture or horticulture. Alright? So, we all know how agriculture, how rice is grown, isn't it? So, we all use the same old tradition. But in future, if I develop a new way to grow my agricultural products, alright? In that moment, if I become the creator of a new technique, how to grow a crop, at that time, I am a creator. Yes, I have invented that the brand new thing. I have developed how to grow crops by using some scientific, or it may be like traditional, in any way. But then also, according to Section 3 and Section 5 of the Patent Rights of 1970, I can't claim for the patent. All right. Number two is, any process under the bracket of medical surgical, curative or other treatment of human beings, animals or plants. So if it is related to medical, surgical or curative treatments to any humans, to any animals or plants, even then I can't go for patent. Why? Because it is for the good of the society. If I create a new vaccine or if I create any medicine which is useful, which will be of greater use to entire society, then I can't claim for the patent according to section 3 and 5. Alright? And the third and the last one is an upgrade or discover of anything that relates to atomic energy. Now, what does atomic energy means? Atomic energy is related with atom bombs or nuclear plants, isn't it? So if I become a scientist, alright, if I become a scientist and if I create a new theory or if I add or if I discover a new thing in atomic science, at that moment I can't go for patent rights. The reason is simple, because it is related to atomic energy, and we all know atomic energy is useful, at the same time it is very dangerous to our humankind. Alright, so these are the three things on which a person or an inventor can't claim for patent according to section 3 and 5 of the patent right. Now, the last one is how to get a patent in India. So we all live in India, and if in tomorrow, in future, if you guys become creators, alright, in any field, like you guys are MPP, some of you might join later on for BALLB, some of you might go for hospitality management, alright, so anything. And in future, supposing if you are a safe, if you become a great safe, alright, or renowned safe, and you come out with a new dish and a new recipe, alright, you have invented your own dish with your own secret recipe, at that moment you can always claim for patent according to Patents Act. You can always go for patent, alright. If you create something, if you invent anything new which is not in existence before, if you become creator in any, you can be a creator in any field, isn't it? You can either be creator of your own recipe, your own food with your secret ingredients, or you can be a software developer and you create a software which will be of a great use and alright. So at that moment you can always claim for patents. Why? So that your invention will not be used by other person without your prior permission or your conscience. Alright? Now, the question is how to get a patent in India. In India, the Patents Act is the central body dealing with filing and regulation of an existing and new patent. This act suggests that either the inventor or one of his legal representatives, in case the inventor is deceased, can apply for one in the head office of Indian Patent Office. So, anyone who has created a new thing, anyone who has created a new or who has developed a new thing, he or she can always file, or he can she can always go for patent in India. Alright? And if the inventor is already dead, alright, if the inventor is deceased, then what we can do? His legal representative can always go and claim for patent. Alright? So I hope you guys have understood the concept of patent. I would like to repeat it again. It's a simple thing. Patents are those rights granted to whom? To the inventors. Alright? So I hope you have understood, and it is one of the branches, as I've already said. Intellectual property, as we can always term it, as a big tree. alright, with many branches. Why? To protect the intellectual thoughts of the inventors or the artists or creators, alright. Under IP Act or Intellectual Property Rights or Law, we have copyrights, alright. Copyrights are for those who invents in the field of music, cinematography, as I've already said. And we can always go for trademark. Trademark is for individual or for a company, so that it will protect your brand's name, alright. And the third one is patent, alright. So patent is basically nothing but it protects the invention of a creator, alright. So on next class, we'll start with social interest versus private interest, alright. That is on Friday, alright. So if you don't understand anything, you can always WhatsApp me or text me, alright. And I will try to help you out. And I have already sent you notes for patents. Please go through it. And if you don't understand, if you have difficulty to understand, then please you can always ask me anytime, alright. And I hope you guys will be safe. Thank you.